Hello.
Morning. Hope today finds you well. We're going to say that. Good. Okay, I'm here. I know you're here. Somebody's here. I can't see any Hello. Thank you. I can't see any stuff on the left hand side, the right hand side of my page here. I know you're here. I saw the hearts. Thanks. Hello. How are you all? Hope this day finds you well. Today is Wednesday. And Wednesday. Yeah, known. Well, no, I won't go into that. Middle of the week. And we have different news this week in such a way that we have extended walking parameters, and that's great. Well done us. Well done that we have it, and hopefully it'll work for us all. And also we have news that our elders are allowed out at certain times during the day. So that's good too. So also that we have to observe the fact that it's their time to be out during the day. So that's cool. And also for somebody actually said it today, I'll say it again, which I thought was quite nice. If you're walking down a street and you see one of your elders walking towards you get out of their way. Don't have it for them to move. And so there you go. That's my contribution, one of them. There you go. Again, I can't see us here. I know there's a few people here, one or two in there. That's great. Thank you. So I'm gonna light a light, and I hope you're well. And again, thanks for joining in. Really appreciate it. And this light is for us to carry on as we are as best we can. And to engage with ourselves as best we can in a positive way, and to be forward thinking about what's going on and how we're going to conduct ourselves when this whole scenario finishes, and how we are going to react to meeting people for the first time, meeting people that we haven't seen for a long time. And all that stuff. So yeah, mind yourself with that, and also just keep your heart lit, keep your heart light, and we'll get through the we've gotten through this is a hard bit. I think there's another hard bit coming up, as in the reintegration. So that's a thing to be aware of and wary of, and mind yourselves how you do that. Because it's going to be joyous. I know this when people see each other for the first time, and it's good. It's a thing to embrace, which is great. So be mindful of that and enjoy it. Enjoy the joyousness of it all. So here's that light for us. Bring it into your heart. Thank you. And let's sage. And this sage is to cleanse the area around us. Reference. And before we go into the meditation, the Reiki session, and this is for you. This is for me. This is for our ancestors, and this is for those around us. This is really hot. I'm gonna put it down there because I don't wanna burn myself. And there you go. So this Reiki session, we're going to. Unfortunately, I can't see anyone joining in or saying hello or whatever. So hello. Whoever's there, really appreciate it. I can't, I've no interaction there. I think Facebook are messing up my whatever they are, algorithms or something, whatever. That's a probably too big a word for this hour of the day, any hour of the day. Anyway, thanks for joining in. I know you're here, and so we're going to do some Reiki, and the Reiki will be for us to mind ourselves. And I ask you that you say to yourself, I'm open and ready to receive. And with that, we will call upon our higher selves to help us with the energy. But before we do that, I'm going to do some smiling. And the smiling, if you smile for, if you use the physical action of smiling for 15 seconds, it releases your serotonin, which is your feel good, thanks for the heart, whoever you may be, I can't see. It releases your serotonin, and your serotonin is your happy, your feel good, your hormone, feel good hormone, happy hormone. And so if you care to join with me for 15 seconds of smiling, please do. So 1, 2, 3. Nowadays are smiley wily. So we're going to do some Reiki, and like I said, the Reiki, we will call upon our higher selves to assist us in this healing. And the words you use are, it's for me, they should be up on the right hand side there, but they're not. I can't see them. I know I posted them. They could be actually below you, wherever you're watching, or wherever, however you're watching. But the what you ask is, you say to yourself, are the words, I'm open and ready to receive. And those words will allow the energy to go where it needs to go, because you've given it permission to do so. So there you go. So I'll see you in a few minutes. All right. Thanks. Now, just bring our hands one over the other. And we'll let the energy grow into a bright white light. We bring that light into our hearts, into our chest. And we let the energy go where it needs to go. Stretch on. And wiggle our toes and wiggle our fingers. And so I'm going to do a reading now. This is the book I'm going to read from, The Medicine Woman Inner Guidebook by Carol Bridges. And that's not an advertisement, that's just me reading the title, just in case some sort of something going on for that. And again, thanks for joining in. What I will ask you to do, I can't see anyone who's here, so that's just the way it is on my computer. But what I would ask you, if you could leave a little smiley face or something in the comments, so I can say hello to you afterwards, or say thanks to you afterwards, whatever. Let me know where you're watching from, even if you're watching the repeat, actually. So yeah, the energies work the same way in the repeat as well, so, or the replay, whatever. So one, thank you for watching right now, and two, if you're watching the repeat, thank you for watching right now. And yeah, really appreciate it. So today's card is the Ten of Stones. There you go. Little heart. I see the hearts and the laugh and the thing. What a whole little hugs. Thank you. That's a hug. Hey, Frankie, I saw you there. Nice one. Thank you. I catch you all later. Ten of Stones. Ten of Stones. Do-do-do-do-do. Come on, lads. There we are. Okay. That was too close. So, the Ten of Stones, accepting recognition. Prayer. My rewards are many at this phase of my career. A good harvest is always certain. People honor me with their purchases. I have earned what I receive. I can relax for a time and rest before I am asked to go on to yet another level of experiencing this work. I can pass some of my wealth onto those behind me and free myself for other things I have begun to desire. It is a rich time in many ways, and greater freedom is coming. Lesson. You have been discovered. A place has been made for you in the marketplace. You have found your niche. This can be an exciting and adventurous period. You may at times long for a quiet role of the student or novice. Fame may tempt you to overwork and overproduce. Use caution. Remember your real values. Keep your priorities straight. Your inner peace and conviction are what brought you here. Don't be tempted to set them aside. You have reached a peak. Always understand that peaks are temporary. Enjoy it. Use it to your advantage and comfortably prepare for the next phase, which will place you in the role of student once again. You will be moving on to a higher level of learning as an apprentice of stones. So each day, each day builds on the day before. So when you reach a peak somewhere along the way, it will plateau. So there are plenty of other peaks in the way, on the way, not in the way, they're on the way. And this can be read in such a way that everything we do, we get experience from doing it, and we use that experience to make ourselves better inside and out. And with that, we can help others do the same. And I find myself working with this, these energies that I work with, I find, obviously, I feel better within myself, and I like to pass this stuff on. The thing I always say for me, okay, this is a personal thing, it works for me, is I use one of the tenets of punk rock. And one, that particular tenet is anyone can do it. Right now, I'm an example of that. If I can do it, so can you. It's a choice we make to do it. That's the thing. So, you know, if you choose not to do it, there you go. Fair enough. Rock and roll. Carry on. Do other things. Whatever. But my point is, whatever you choose to do, do it with love. Do it with integrity. Do it with self-love as well. Like, love of doing it is one thing, which is great, and loving to help others is great too. But this love here, it has to come from within first, and then you can spread the word, as the saying goes. So yeah, I enjoy doing this. It's great for me, you know, whatever. And I I do believe people are getting some benefit out of it, and that's great too. And thank you for your feedback; I really appreciate it. And but for me, this is all punk rock. Yeah, believe it or not, and you know, if you believe it, winner. If you don't, winner. So whatever. But my point is, if it wasn't for me believing in that tenet, anyone can do it, I wouldn't be doing this. So whatever it is you do for yourself to bring yourself forward with no harm to none, of course, including yourself, that's a great thing. So anyone can do it. Anyone can smile. Anyone can be happy. Anyone can choose to do whatever it is to help yourself and to help others. But you can't pour from an empty cup. So remember, within yourself, feel yourself first, feed yourself first, then share. Okay, then share, then help, whatever, and nurture and develop. So so yeah, there you go. So onwards and upwards. So now we're gonna do some drumming. I think we're gonna do some reading, see if I can find a poem. Okay, Soundings again, school book. It's a reprint, and I got it from Reread, dear friend. So thank you. Okay, The Retreat by Henry Vaughan. Happy those early days when I shined in my angel infancy, before I understood this place appointed for my second race, or taught my soul to fancy aught but a white celestial thought, when yet I had not walked above a mile or two from my first love, and looking back at that short space, could see a glimpse of his bright face, when on some gilded cloud or flower my gazing soul would dwell on hour, and in those weaker glories spy some shadows of eternity, before I taught my tongue to wound my conscience with a sinful sound, or had the black art to dispense a several sin to every sense, but felt through all this fleshy dress bright shoots of everlastingness. Oh, how I long to travel back and tread again that ancient track, that I might once more reach that plain where first I left my glorious train, for whence the enlightened spirit sees that shady city of palm trees. But, ah, my soul with too much stay is drunk and staggers in the way. Some men of forward motion love, but I by backward steps would move. And when this dust falls on the urn, in that state I came return. There you are. Right. Drumming. We will do some drumming. The drumming will last for 10 minutes. It is another form of meditation. And I will then do a minute of, or a time of callbacks here. Subconscious. We'll be able to come back. So before I do that, again, I shall warm up my drum. And so a big shout, big hello to you all. Thank you for joining in. Still can't see who's here. And I know you're here, so thanks. So let me know where you're watching from, whether you're watching live here now or where you're watching the repeat here now. And we're going to do the rattle, and the rattle will connect us to the heavens, and the drum will connect us to the earth, and we'll be in between like a child of the earth. So see you in a few minutes, all right? Thanks.
Thank you. Yeah, there you are. Welcome back. I'm going to do some more Reiki now in a minute. And flick of the hair because I can. So yeah, nice one. Thanks for joining in. Really appreciate it. And hope today finds you well. It's a glorious sunny day. Hope you get out for a little wander. Or at the very least, hope your window gets some fresh air inside you. And yeah. So we are coming towards the end of current difficult times, and I don't mean to sound bold when I say that, of course, because we have to adjust now to the new normal, for want of a word, or the new way. And in some respects, I would hope that there's some old ways we don't go back to. Now that's personal. Now that mightn't be the current reflection. But there are certainly some things that we need to address, obviously within ourselves, but also in for the greater good. And I know plenty of people who are doing so already, which is great. And I obviously endeavor to do so myself. And yeah, so we leave that for another day. I don't want to get too political here because that's not the point of this. This is a different thing. So I will read from the Goddess guidance cards and see what has to be said, or is to be said, not has to be said, excuse me. Just loosen them up a bit. A few of them caught up in themselves. Maybe. So yeah, I hope your day's going well. And again, appreciate you joining in or passing through or whatever. And we're going to do some more Reiki in a minute. But first of all, we see what goddess of guidance is for today. This one here is Ishtar, boundaries. Love yourself enough to say no to others. Love yourself enough to say no to others' demands on your time and energy. I think that is actually going a little bit towards what I just said about coming into the new ways. It mightn't be, could easily be. We'll see. But there are some that believe that Ishtar is also the meaning of where Easter comes from. HIJKEFG. And mightn't be, but you know, whatever and stuff. So, Ishtar, boundaries. Love yourself enough to say no to others' demands on your time and energy. Message from Ishtar or Easter, whatever. A sincere desire to give of service is wonderful. However, there's a distinction between giving of yourself and giving up yourself. If you feel tired, guilty, or resentful while helping others, then you're not truly helping them, are you? You're injecting poisonous energies into the relationship, and then no one benefits. Step back and reassess the situation. As you respect your own boundaries, others will begin to recognize and respect them within you and within themselves as well. Now, that's a healthy behavior to teach others. The various meanings of this card. You're giving too much. Become more assertive. Don't do things out of guilt or observation or obligation. Excuse me. About Ishtar, she's been worshipped and evoked since ancient Babylonian times as the embodiment of Venus's womanly energy. Ishtar represents the divine feminine in all of her aspects, including nurturing, mothering, sensuality, fertility, healing, protection, and wisdom. As a multidimensional goddess, Ishtar doesn't tire of helping the men and women who call upon her for assistance. So ask, call upon Ishtar for assistance with your boundaries. Excuse me, boundaries. Because we are learning all about them ourselves. So there you go. So Ishtar rocks. Thank you. So now I'm going to do some more Reiki. And this Reiki will be for the frontline workers, multitudinous frontline workers, the nurses, the doctors, all the hospital staff, including the cleaners, the porters, the cooks, chefs, food operators, food deliverers, the supermarket workers, people who are told not to give up their work. For those actually, now this frontline workers who
There's a lot of people who, this is for them as well now, for people who are not finding it quite difficult at the moment, and I definitely want to send all our love and energy to them as well, because it's going to be a slow process of reopening ourselves, and obviously, you know, integration back onto the, literally back onto the streets. And for those who are quite shy or reticent or in any way not so outgoing as others, so we need to observe them, help them, nurture them to help them become more integrated into what's going on. And so this is for them as well. And socially shy people, whatever, I can be, and that's fair enough too. That's a choice I make. So we need to introvert, you know, the introverts who are the extroverts actually as well, actually, because I think the extroverts possibly are having a hard time because they can't be out. So maybe anyway, back to the frontline workers, the people working in the shops, the people supplying the food, the farmers, the firefighters, the army, the Gardaí, the military, the air force, the air corps, the street cleaners, the bin collection types, there's a proper phrase for them, I can't remember, whatever, street hygiene maintenance, and so, but definitely the nurses and the doctors, certainly the nurses anyway, and may they get what they need and deserve, because there's a lot of politics going on about them as well, so they need serious help, more than a clap on a Thursday night, Your Honour. So let's go there. So this is for them, and I invite you to say the words, I'm open and ready to receive, and we will call upon your higher selves to help. And yeah, so see you in a few minutes. And again, I ask you if you'd care to join me in, we all sit together as if we're all holding hands in a big circle, because one day I know we will. I look forward to that. All right. So again, so I'm open and ready to receive, and I'll see you in a few minutes. All right. Thanks.
Yeah, if we bring our hands together, bring ourselves back, bring our hands together, and let the energy grow into a bright white light. Maybe bring the energy into our hearts. Let it sit there for a moment. And then we let the energy go where it needs to go. We stretch, we yawn. And we wiggle our fingers and we wiggle our toes. And there you are. So now, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining in. Really appreciate it. May your day go well. And may your God go with you. And I will see you the next time. So again, thanks for joining in. If you're watching the repeat, thanks for joining in. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you out there someday. All right. So love and light and rock and roll. Love you. Don't forget to love yourself. It's your job. Okay. Okay. Mind yourselves. Love yourselves. Nurture yourselves. And be the coolest thing ever. I know about that. Thank you. Love you. La la la. Mm-hmm.